Reverend Dr. Mello Desiree from the Cuban Warriors Foundation 1% campaign. We're standing in front of the federal building today, January 18th, in honor of our fallen youth who was murdered unjustifiably. Up here we have Monet Jackson. He was murdered on Mother's Day off Manchester and Figueroa with three other friends who were injured, as well as Marion, who was also killed. We have Hannah Bell, who was murdered on Western and Florence at a burger joint eating with her mother. She was only 15 years old. And we have one of our prized possession mentors, Anthony J. Weber, who was just 16 years old when sheriffs opened fire 13 times on this young boy, giving him no outlet or no way of escape, labeling them as gang members. These three are wrongful deaths, along with many, many of our young people in Los Angeles County who lost their lives due to law enforcement, lack of resources, or just lack of safety in general. What we'd like to do is highlight the needs of our youth in a way where it is monetarily reciprocal to our kids. This year, we'll be filing several wrongful death lawsuits against the County of Los Angeles, having the responsibility of LAPD, of Sheriff's Department, being held accountable for the deaths of our children. Monet Jackson wanted to be a dancer. He was a straight-A student. He had no affiliations with gangs whatsoever. But while he was shot, him and his friend LaMarion, the police labeled this as a gang-related shooting, which is what delayed the hospital. The help to Monet to save his life was delayed. Instead of having him go to the hospital right away, 11 hours had passed before any help was given, and by then it was too late. For Anthony J. Weber, he was simply leaving a football game, and he was approached by three sheriffs who were asking him questions. They didn't even allow him to speak, and while Anthony was running, they shot him in the back. 9 bullets was found in his back. We want to honor these students in a fine arts institute that will give them freedom to save in a safe place and not be casualties. As the LAUSD strikes continue, as our teachers continue not to get paid enough, as our students continue not to have the resources, we need to stop this now. And the only way to stop it is through accountability, through lawsuits. So the families and friends of the fallen victims of our young people in LA County will not be faced in vain. Their deaths are not in vain. So I want you to join us and join the movement. Log on to www.1percentage.org, where you'll find updates and ways to join the movement. Join us February 23rd in South LA, where we will have auditions for our young people who have no resources other than basketball, football, drill, track, truck driving, security jobs. A lot of limited resources going to our youth, especially in deprived areas such as South LA. So this is the year where we need a change. This is the year where we need action. This is the year where we need to force new laws that will help protect the constituents of LA County, that will help protect the future of our young people, and that will help raise the rights of our constituents. We are tired of the lack of resources by our local politicians who do not use our tax dollars to help the people. Instead, most of our funding is going into staffing for county and city employees, the organization and their administration, and the homeless funding, most of it goes to staffing. Probation dollars, most of it goes to the probation officers, and not to the programs, not to the juveniles suffering in the jail system. We focus on prevention and early intervention. We focus on wellness recovery action plans. We focus on mental health, but we cannot do it alone. We must stand united. We must stand firm. And this is the year where accountability will be heard. So please join us and log on to our Facebook 1% campaign, or log on to our website 1percentage.org. Let your voice be heard. I'm Reverend Dr. Mello Desiree, constituent for the Los Angeles County, and I represent the disenfranchised of America.